let me share my wisdom that I introduced, but I think that that actually gives me answers about my curiosity about the genres caused by the technology development. I remember you must don't worry about the genres, right? Yeah, anyway, I have to start my presentation. Firstly, I am introduced to new innovation technologies and human genres. Pricewaterhouse performed a survey in 2014 question about what interests from the way people work over the next 5 to 10 years. 10 years with 10,000 ordinary persons in the world. The result was not out of expected. A total of 53% of respondents said that the technological breakthrough, the innovation, is the most effective factor for the job change. Because that it is now widely accepted fact that the technological advancement, such as a robot or AI, putting people out of the work and will destroy more human jobs in the future. Has anyone of you seen this picture before? Anyone? No? Yeah, this picture was posted at the online newspaper 4 years ago at a certain United States online newspaper. Because I majored in the automated highway system, I'm very interested in the self-driving car, but the concept is a little bit different. But when I saw this picture for the first time, I was very surprised. Because I had expected that the first commercialization business model of self-driving car is the public transportation. But that time, 2012, was so fast as I expected, because the technology was not mature for commercialization. Also, the society was not ready to accept the self-driving car. But I know that day I saw this picture was the 1st of April. You know, the April 1st day newspaper. In the newspaper, I saw this picture. But this is the title of this picture. But this picture. But the picture of April 1st day came true. This is the title of newspaper of the next year. The Google announced that it will establish the separate independent taxi firm to take over the Uber. And more and more last week, I saw the news that Singapore announced that began to trial driving with self-driving taxi ahead of the launch of the commercial robot taxi service in 2 years. But not only for the Singapore, but also Helsinki, Tokyo, and Philadelphia are ready to start the public transportation service using a self-driving car. Who knows that this kind of service could begin this year? But the big issue of self-driving car is the human job unemployment. As the speed of new technology progress enter market quickly, it occurs as social issues at the same time. In case of self-driving car, it is predicted that the job in the area of the insurance and sales and repair and driver's license business would be disappeared or reduced. A certain feature is expected that the Uber self-driving car will destroy the 10 million jobs in the world by 2025. Even if in Korea, there is no self-driving car on the road, many workers of such areas already worry about their job loss. So far, I only commented the self-driving car as an example of the relation between the technology advance and human unemployment. Yeah, this year, as all of you see this picture, this year is two times of shocking news for a human job. One is the feature of job report published by the WF. Yeah, they are expected that 5 million jobs will be disappeared in 5 years, especially focused on the office and administration and manufacturing and production. And the second shock is the history being matched between Sedol Lee. He is the one of the world's best Korean Go players, and AlphaGo, which is the artificial intelligence system developed by DeepMind. Also, there are interests in many countries. The impact of the actual confrontation took place in Korea was rivaled than any other country. Especially the fact the artificial intelligence and robot can replace the job seemed to be a big shock. Until 2 or 3 years ago, we thought that smartphone or the smart pad are the innovation technology and devices for the future. But now it is changing. But this kind of new innovation triggering technologies had the problem. The problem is that the kind of new innovation technologies is affecting the human employment. I already mentioned about the self-driving cars, but the robot, this is a paper. This is a paper and already utilized in the service field and at the home as well as the factory. And AI, AlphaGo, and the others plays a role of the human brain engagement with the various systems. Also the drone. This system plays in agriculture, safety guard, as well as the logistics, and they perform the human roles already. This picture is the General Electric factory in India. This smart factory mainly produces various industrial products such as the jet engines and turbines. And the production and assembly process are optimized by themselves depending on the customer's order using 3D printers and the Internet of Things and robot and AI. After launching the equipment, the factory automatically monitors the status of the component through a sensor attaching to the product. The smart factory also seems to play a large role in reducing the human work. This is the development phase of the automation. In my perspective, there are 2 points of view of the human job and the way of working change. First, now we already faced the full automation era. New innovation triggering technologies, as Doja mentioned, can substitute for almost the human role. Yeah, second is the change of the pattern of human and machine working space. The left picture, yeah, this one, is a traditional working space called the human-machine interface or human-computer interaction space. This space exists in a real physical world. The human and the machine complete a scientific work and work by helping together. But this kind of working space is changed by the introduction of new innovation system. And most of the systems use the cloud technologies so that the user and engineer should consider the two spaces. One is the physical world, then the human and machine working together, and the other is the cyber world, a cyberspace that AI and software is activating. Let's suppose to the AlphaGo and Sedol Lee's match in Seoul. There is no need to ship a computer in Seoul, but the software and AI are running in cloud system in the United States. Yeah, second part is the impact of technological effect of the employment. Yeah, first I'll show the representative graph that describes the correlation between the productivity and employment of the United States. This graph has a title support Joseph's name. That represents the decoupling between the productivity and employment of the United States from the 20s. First suggested by the economist Gerard Bernstein. This graph explains the productivity growth and employment growth started to become decoupled from each other at the end of the this decade. And yeah, this is a copy of the New York Times. And Eric Greer Croson and Andrew McAfee explained the two regions of this great decoupling. The first is the computer will never keep getting cheaper over time. And this labor will become cheaper than human labor, not only in the United States, and but also in the places like China and India. And second, technologies are going to continue to become more powerful and to acquire more advanced skills and abilities like a human. So they insisted that the great decoupling is not going to reverse course. But there are several optimistic opinions that the technological development increased the human jobs. I collected several cases. First is the employment multiplier of the United States. As the factory is smarter and more advanced, the multiplier increased significantly. It means that even if the workers of the job shop, direct job, is decreased by the advance of technology, but the indirect job, such as the consulting or IT workers that are working out of the factory, will be increased significantly to support and maintain the factory. The graph explaining the fact that the indirect job, overcome the direct job in the United States in 2005. Well, I'm sorry. The last question is good. Yeah, this is second case is the smart factory in Germany. Both the consulting group analyzed that when the German companies adopted the smart factory, about 350,000 jobs are created in major 23 industry fields. And also they suggested that the human machine interface engineers and mathematicians and algorithm experts job will be increased in the near future. Also there is a Moravec paradox. It is comparatively easy to make computers. It means that it is comparatively easy to make computers as with other reliable purposes of intelligent tests or price checkers, and difficult or impossible to give them at the scale of 1 year old when it comes to perception and mobility. Also, the McKinsey investigated the human just in terms of the work activities and the human capability. The result is fewer than 5% of occupations cannot entirely automated using current technology. This result indicated that there is no need to worry about the job loss in the near future. Part 3, I'll explain the current situation. Currently, unemployment the technology advance is in progress in Korea. 7,000 toll of the highway are faced to lose the jobs by the change of total toll gate into unmanned one until 2020. Also, the internet, smart banking, and the robot advisor replaced the human bankers very fastly. And the unmanned subway is started to use in a new subway system 4 years ago. And this is also the research result of the Boston Consulting. They suggest that the Korean manufacturers will get the biggest benefit of the human labor cost saving among 25 countries by the adoption of the robots in 2025. It means that the elimination of the human employment of the factory will be disappear. Also, Korean Employment Information Service Organization analyzed the low and high job replacement possibility by automation until 2020 using the same algorithm of Dr. Prey and Osman of the Oxford University. But results are very different. Low possibility of replacement job is painters, photographers, authors and composers, animators and dancers and so on, that is related to the kind of arts. But the Osman's result is that the management, business, and financial, and computer engineering science, education, legal, and so are expertise area. I think that the country kind of then we already see the both sides graph of Joseph Snake. And I also drew the same graph using the Korean productivity and employment data from 1917, because the productivity data started calculating from that year. But the shape are very different. If the US graph shape is the Joseph Stank, I think this is a kind of Joseph the crocodile, maybe. And anyway, of course, the Korean government pushes the industrialization policy from 1970s, the productivity increased dramatically, but the employment do not face with the increase of the productivity. Yesterday, I saw the also Dr. Atkinson's interview from the Bloomberg, and he commented about this graph. He said no great decoupling is taking place. Employment, you keep working down the decline still with the working age population. So also, I drew the Korean data, but I think that there is a correlation between the working population and the total employment, but because of the Korean productivity increasing very dramatically, that the shape is very different between two countries. And conclusion, I think, anyway, this is my preliminary study of the relation between technology device and unemployment. But I'm watching the concept of indirect job. Because of many ordinary people has the anxiety about losing their job by the advance of the technology, but most of the person do not have the concept of indirect job. So also there is no how can I say that? There is no statistics and no guide about the indirect job. So I need indirect job. So we need a study more about that. Also because the pattern of technological unemployment may be different for countries by the industrial structures, labor policy, education system, and so on. I think that we should expert and countries sharing the related policy information, practice, and case studies, and sharing it together, and it will be very helpful for the innovation policy design and for the decrease of the robotics or AI-based. This is the end of my presentation. Thank you.